in marching against the Lord God of hosts.
He said, hear me,
for I will make an utter end of it. He said, an affliction shall not rise the same time. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Affliction shall not rise once the same time.
Can I tell you something this morning? In every rising, in every repeating of an affliction, there is always a condition of a strong man. Affliction cannot repeat itself twice, three times, four times, except if there is what? A strong man behind. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
What makes an affliction to repeat itself again and again is because there is a strong man behind. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So if challenges must repeat itself again and again, something is empowering affliction. And that force that is empowering affliction is a strong man behind. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
You are going to pray this morning. I said, God, I don't know if you are ready for this service. I said that your blessing today must not pass you by. So if you know that you are here to collect your blessing, you must be ready to collect either by thunder or by fire.
Yeah, yeah.
Am I speaking to someone?
Yeah, yeah.
So if you are here to collect your blessing, I can't imagine you sitting down if there is no reason for you to sit down. If you know you are sound, you are healthy to stand up and you are sitting down, it means you are not ready for the service. Because the service is kindled with fire.
Yeah.
So if you are here to receive, you must receive by fire.
That's true.
From the days of the John the Baptist, even until now, the kingdom of God suffered violence. And it's only those who are violent can do what? So I am here to collect mine by force. I don't know about you. I am here to collect my own baraka. I don't know about you. Devil does not respond to your beautiful faces. He does not respond to how you treat him. What devil responds is your action. I'm asking you to someone. An affliction shall not rise the second time. So you are going to pray this one and say, God, any strong man behind my repeated afflictions, as I pray today, fall down and die. I'm asking you to someone. Son of affliction, problems, challenges in my life, in my family, this morning will not escape you. As I pray today, sir, let the strong man, anywhere you are you in any coffin, in any altar, fall down and die. My father, my father.
Awake your glory. I am here this morning to awake your glory back to function. If your glory is not functionable, a lot of things pass you by. Praise God. If your glory is not alert, a lot of things, the angels of God can render blessings. Yeah, yet the blessings will pass you by. But that is not your portion this morning. Because I came here with a mission.
Amen.
And that mission is that your blessing must locate you.
Amen.
Your favor will not pass you by.
Amen.
If you believe that, shout fire.
Fire.
If you believe that, shout fire.
Fire.
If you believe that, shout Jesus.
Jesus.
And the Bible said in John chapter 19 verse 11, and Jesus answered Pilate saying, no man, no power can exercise control over me
except if it is given thee from above.
He said, no man can exercise power over me except if that power, the authority, comes from what? From above. This should be the mental picture of every believing child of God. In any condition, in any situation you find yourself, in any challenge of life you find yourself, the mental picture, your mental focus should be that in this situation, you have no charge, you have no power over me. As long as your sanction is not from what? From above. Because you came from above. And the Bible said that whatever is from above is above all. Jesus said, Pilate, it doesn't matter who you are. If you like, be the governor of the Jews. If you like, be the oracle of Jews. But hear me and hear me clearly. He said, no man, no man, no authority. Have charge, have control over me. Except if that authority is given to you from my Father that is above. So there are situations that we are in life today. There are conditions that we are present in life today. Your mental focus, your mental picture should be in this condition. As long as your roots, your connection is from not above, he said, you have no control over me.
Yes.
This sickness, you have no control. You are going to pray this morning. Any satanic pattern from my mother's house, from my father's house, taking over the shape of my destiny. As I pray today, because I am purchased by the blood, your time is expired.
Amen.
I don't know if somebody's getting it. I don't know if somebody's getting it. Lord, as I pray today, I am purchased by the blood. There is no greater sacrifice than the blood that was shed on the cross for you. By the blood you have redemption. The Bible says there is no other foundation that can be laid other than the one that has been led by Christ. Christ took himself to the cross and he slaughtered himself in order to erase any sacrifice. But you must understand it and you hold on it and the fight what you need to fight. That is fight. You must fight. If you must break up to some extent, you must fight. Whether you like it or not, it's either you pray a pleasure or you pray a pressure. I don't even understand what I'm saying. So there is two things. Choose one. So you are going to pray and say every family pattern, satanic pattern, taking charge over the shape of my destiny. As I pray today, your time is up.
Amen.
I am purchased by blood, expire.
Amen.
My Father! My Father, my Father, my helper. As I begin to pray, every satanic family, family pattern, taking shape over my life, taking control over my destiny. I am purchased by the blood. Your time is up. Expire, my Father. Don't put your mouth and pray.
Open your Bible with me, the book of Exodus chapter 14.
We read from 13 and verse 14. Praise God.
Gina, the title of this message is Entering My Promised Land. Praise God. Entering My Promised what? Land. Praise God. You can stand up, let us read the scripture together. Ezra chapter 14, verse 13 to verse 14. And the Bible says, And Moses said unto the people, Fear ye not, stand still and see the salvation of God, which he will show to you this day. For the Egyptians whom ye have seen today, ye shall see them again no more. You can be seated. The Egyptians that you see today, the afflictions that you are seeing today, the conditions you are seeing today, that unaccompanied condition you are seeing today, the Bible say, you shall see them no more. He said, fear you not, because there is always a time for everything. There is time of the beginning of affliction, and there is also a time to end affliction. The children of Israel suffered many years in the land of Egypt. They passed through a lot of hell. They suffered afflictions. They suffered slavery. They suffered many things. Because the time they were suffering is the time expected for them in affliction. But a time came. A time came for them to be liberated. A time came for them to get free from the affliction. A time came for them to God save from what they have been suffering over the years. Despite the signs, despite the wonders that God directed in the land of Egypt, a lot of things happened. The prophets of God were there. Moses were there. Aaron were there. A lot of God, they declared signs and wonders. Yet Pharaoh said, no. He said, thou art going nowhere. The firstborns were slaughtered. The floods flew everywhere, even the palace of Pharaoh. The waters were turned to red. We are turned to blood. Floods, everything. Caterpillar, the edge of the grass. A lot of signs were erected. Wonders in the land of Egypt. But yet, Pharaoh held the people of Israel. It did not occur to Pharaoh. I am here to announce to you this day. I don't know the situation that have persisted in your life. I don't know the affliction that have refused to go. I don't know that stubborn condition that have refused to go. But hear me and hear me this morning. By the virtue of this encounter, by the anointing of God in the house this morning, I here declare, you shall see them no more. The Egyptians now see them today. Shall see them no more. That is time for everything under the sun. That is time always for beginning of things. And that is always a time for things to end. You may have passed through things. You may have prayed. You may have fasted. You may have trusted God. But I'm here to tell you this morning that by your trusted time, that your trusted accomplishment, that your trusted decision has come this morning. I said it has come this morning. Egyptians you see today, thou shall see them no more. Amen. And the word of God said, and God told Moses, he said, fear not, because there is something strong that waits for you. If you can fear for what you are seeing now, what about the things that you are about to see? Am I speaking to someone? If you must enter your promised land, there are four key divine factors from the scripture we read that you must know, you must embark on before you can get entrance, before you can enter, before you can access your promised land. What is promised land? What is promised land in the days of Moses and the people of Israel may not be your own promised land today. Your breakthrough may be your promised land. Your expectation job may be your promised land. I don't have visa. I need visa. That may be your promised land. I don't have a driving license. I need a full shot. That may be your promised land. I don't have a wife. I need a wife. That may be your promised land. I don't have a child. You need a child. That might be your promised land. I don't have a baby. You need a baby. That might be your promised land. I don't have this. I don't have that. I need my blessing. That might be your promised land. But if you must enter your promised land, if you must possess your promised land, you must remember there are sons of what? Anak. And the Bible said, fear not. So one thing that you must know, you must learn not what to fear. Fear. You must keep fear. That is number one. The Bible said, fear not. When God promised the people of Israel the promised land, God did not tell them they are sons of Anak. God didn't tell them they are resting. God didn't tell them there are this or that, but God just promised them. He just gave them the promised land. But they thought that accessing my promised land is as free as God has said it. No. Every promised land of every life, of every man, seeketh for. You must learn not to fear. You must learn to gather supernatural momentum. Praise God. Hallelujah. You said fear not. And the Bible said in 2 Timothy 1:7, he said, for I have not given down the spirit of fear, but of spirit of power, love, and of sound words, mind. Your mind must be saturated. Your mind must be free as anything. Your mind must be far from fear if you must enter your promised land. Because in promised land, there is a lot of constraint. In promised land, there is a lot of barriers. In promised land, there is a lot of bridges that one need to cross before thou can enter into your promised land. If you must cross any bridge that stops your promised land, if you must cross any bridge, any rescue that leads to your promised land, you must learn not to fear. And the Bible said that God said to Moses, tell these people, fear not. Because fear is an agent of destruction. Fear is an agent of denial. The only thing that can succeed to deny your blessing when you have not come close to the blessings is fear. Fear works in two ways. Praise God. When you are doing something good, that is fear. You want to go into something, fear will come. It doesn't matter how pure, how righteous what you want to do is, fear will appear. When you are doing something bad, fear will also what? Appear. That is why the Bible made it clear. He said, for I have not given thou the spirit of fear. The spirit I give you is the spirit of boldness. The spirit I give you is the spirit of power. Power to conquer, power to overrule, power to exercise dominion. It doesn't matter the rest. I am giving you power to cross. It doesn't matter the bridges. It doesn't matter the barriers. I am giving you power to conquer the barriers. It doesn't matter any opposition you are seeing in life, whether right or left, whether front or back. The power I have given to you is enough to conquer.
Amen.
In order to enter what? Your promised land. I have given you the spirit of servant, the spirit of a clear mind, a clear thought, the spirit of a prosperous mind. This is what I've given to you. So if you must enter your promised land, you must conquer the factor of fear. You must conquer fear completely. David said, oh, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointed my hand with oil, and my cup runneth over. He said, surely thy goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord. I shall dwell in the presence.
Oh yeah.
I fear no evil, for God are with me. It doesn't matter what I am seeing. It does not matter what is standing as an opposition to me. It does not matter the rest seeing. It does not matter the degree, the height of the rest I am seeing. Yet, I fear no evil. I walk in the shadow that is death and I march on death. Because I know my Redeemer is better. Because I know the one that is with me is greater than he that is on the wall. Because I know that what I carry is not about victory. What I carry, I am more than a conqueror. What I carry fire that no man can stop. What I carry is ahead of his victory. I see no other thing but victory. I see no other thing because I am overcomer. I see no other thing because God has lifted me above my challenges. Because when fear creeps in, when fear comes to mind, what comes to mind is failure. Yes. So if you must enter your promised land, you must learn to deal with fear. Praise God. You must learn to deal with fear. You say fear not. The first thing that God told Abraham. Because fear has entered already. Even Moses himself. This is why Moses
was crying.
Have to go to God. After Moses have told them, when you study that scripture, you see that Moses have already made statement first to the people of Israel. And when fear came, he now ran back to God. Praise God. And God said, Moses, move forward. He said, fear not. Tell them not to fear. Because I am that I am is with you. I am the Lord of hosts. The Bible said, have you not heard that the creator, the everlasting God, the creator of the heavens and earth, neither faint nor slumber. I am with you. I give strength to him that have no strength. To him that have no power, I increase his might. It doesn't matter, the youth may run and faint. They may grumble. The years, the God does not change. Then I went upon the Lord shall have their strength renewed. Assess your breakthrough, if you must collect your visa, if you must collect your blessing, you must take fear out of your direction. Nothing can hinder you in life except fear. When there is fear, you have given yourself an opposition already, because fear stands as an opposition. Fear starts as a door. So you are pleading to get fear out of your way. Your height in life cannot be defined by the forces. Because of what? You have succeeded to remove fear from your direction. The Bible said, as the spies were set, Caleb and Joshua, they came back with a different report, sir. And other people that saw the source of Anak, they were gripped by what? By fear. Fear colonized them. But these ones that escaped fear, these ones that took fear to boldness, they came back with another result, saying, leave these people. It doesn't matter how quality they are. It does not matter how dirty they are. As long as we have the Lord of hosts on our side, promised land belongs to us. Amen. What is the report that the Lord has given to you? What is the news that the doctor has given to you? Who told you you cannot born? Who told you you cannot do great in life? Who told you that you cannot marry? Who told you you cannot do something? Whose report shall thou believe? Report of man or report of God? The Bible said, to him that have believed our report, to him shall the hand of the Lord. See, you can't enter into the grace of God's manifestation, the grace of miracles, without believing. He said, he that have believed our report, first of all, you must believe the report of God. If you must assess your breakthrough, if you must access your promised land, you must first of all believe
the report of God. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
And the word of God said, he said, stand still. So this number two factor that you must know is to learn to stand what? Still. You must learn to stand focused. Come spread, come shine. It doesn't matter what you see. It doesn't matter who is fighting you. It doesn't matter where that vision is coming from. It doesn't matter who is standing as an opposition to you. It doesn't matter the source of anarchy by your side, by your way. The Bible says what? Stand still. In other words, be focused. If you must enter your promised land of any segment, virtue in life, you must learn to stand still. You must learn to be what? To be focused. I will say in Isaiah 40, he said, when thou pass through the water, I will be with you. When thou pass through the rivers, I will not allow the river to overflow you. When thou pass through the fire, I will not allow the fire to burn you. Then thou will I allow the scorch, the flame to scorch you. You must learn to be focused. It doesn't matter the river you are seeing. It doesn't matter the fire you are seeing. Whether the fire is coming from your mother, whether the fire is coming from your father, stand still. Be focused. Number two thing that can help you to enter your promised land is to be focused. Caleb was focused. Joshua was focused. Moses did not go down there. They were only sent to go as far. When they came back, they did not allow anything to distract them. They didn't allow the reports of their colleagues. You are 10. Out of 10, 8 is fighting 2 people. But 2 people stood against the 10. Do you know the gravity of that opposition? Do you know the gravity of that pressing? Do you know the gravity of that challenge? 10 out of 10, 2 people stood in dominion against the 8 people. Because of what? They were focused. So what you are telling me does not matter. What matters is that is a place I'm going. What matters is my promised land I must enter. What matters is that my breakthrough I must collect. What matters is my visa is coming. What matters is everything my expectation of God is certain. They remain what? Focused. They never came, yet they remain focused. The waters came, they remain focused. The fire came, they remain focused. The scorches came, the flame came, they remain focused. Because of what? Promised land. I must enter my promised land. Praise God. Because of time, the God factor you must see there, he says, see the salvation of God. Let me tell you something. If you want to make it in life, you must be an expectator of success. You can't be successful in life if you don't carry success in life. Am I speaking to someone? He says, see the salvation of God. So if you must enter your promised land, the only picture that you will see in life is the picture of success. I'm asking you to someone. You can't be seeing failure and be expecting success. It's not all. So if you must see success, the only picture you must learn to see, sir, is success. Because it's what you see, this is what you can access. What you do not see, you cannot access. Am I speaking to someone? He says, see the salvation of God. In other words, stop seeing the Red Sea. In other words, stop seeing the oppositions. In other words, stop seeing bridges. Stop seeing barriers. Stop seeing destruction. Keep seeing the salvation of God. Keep seeing success ahead of you. Keep seeing victory ahead of you. Keep seeing delivery ahead of you. Keep seeing breakthrough ahead of you. He says, see. The salvation of God. In other words, you are not allowed, if you want to enter your promised land, in the journey, you are not allowed to see barriers. You are not allowed to see failure. Other people sir. Other people ran away. Every other people sir collapsed. But they keep seeing. They keep seeing. The Bible says that, yeah, I'm more than conqueror. If you know that you are more than conqueror, you are not permitted to see failure. You are not permitted to see defeat. Because all that is born of God overcometh the world. The Bible said that this is the victory that overcometh the world. What even the high faith? So your faith was turned to that of success expectant. Success must be your mental picture. Success must be your mental view. No matter what you are seeing today, no matter where you are today, though I may come last, but my coming first at the end is certain. Though I may be last today, but you can't tell what will happen tomorrow. I may not have a car today. I may not have a visa today. I may not have money today. But even in the days of Jeremiah, Jeremiah from their tribe. Go and study the scripture. Nobody was a prophet. Nobody was a man of God. But Pharaoh took Jeremiah from square one to the end. Jacob was busy burning through the here and there from different wives. But at last, the son of his own age took them from where they were to the palace. Where you are today does not matter. What matters is where you are going tomorrow. You must learn to see the salvation of God. You must learn to see the victory ahead of you. You must learn to see the rising of you. You must learn to see the shining ahead of you. You must learn to see the greater breakthrough ahead of you. The Bible says the laborers were brought into the vineyard. The first time, the second time, the third time, the fourth time, yet they remember the hour. But somebody came last and he received the money. He said, after many times, after many months, after many years, he's coming last. He has lost hope. He said, I stood here, master, because nobody hired me. Nobody agreed to take me. This is why I'm standing here. All hope is lost. But there is one thing that is certain. The Bible said that hope maketh not die ashamed. Though he was helpless, but he was standing. Can I tell you the mystery behind his standing? He was helpless. He was hopeless, but he was standing because he has his victory in mind. He has his promised land in mind. Otherwise, no one hired him. He has stood morning, afternoon, night. He would have gone back to the house. Am I speaking to someone here? He would have returned to the house, but he remained there because his promised land is in his heart. He carried it in his heart. Though you are not seeing, though people were not seeing, people were busy seeing his recklessness. People were busy seeing his situation. People were busy seeing his condition. People were busy seeing everything they are seeing. But he carried his promised land in the heart. In the heart. So if you must enter your promised land, you must learn to see the salvation of God. The fourth one is placing God first. Praise God. God told Moses, he said, go ahead. The problem you have is because you are looking at this thing. The problem you have is because you want to take the battle to yourself. The problem you are seeing, you are facing today is because you have refused to acknowledge God first. God is the giver of promised land. So if you must enter promised land, you must learn to bless the one that gives you promised land first. Am I speaking to someone?
Yes.
They fought the battle on their own. They saw the Red Sea. In their mind, they concluded that they are gone. They saw the situation. In their mind, they concluded that it's over. This is why they started crying. They didn't remember the same God that brought them out of Egypt is able to bring them to the promised land. but in vain. They never ask them what but in vain. Except they not build the house, they build out. They build but in vain. Except the Lord keep watch over the city. They watch men. They watch even. Then he said, I look up unto the hills. He said, from where cometh my help? He said, my help cometh from God that made heaven and earth. He said, that God shall not suffer thy foot to move. He said, he that giveth Israel, he neither sleep nor slumber. You must learn to bless God first. When God is first, every other thing follows. It becomes terror for you. It becomes terror. God first, and every other thing follows. He said, when thou delight thy ways on the Lord, he said, and the Lord shall bring thy desire to an accomplishment. Expectation of the righteous shall not cut off. But God must be first. If your expectation cannot cut off, you must learn to place God first. God, I leave this situation for you. I leave the battle for you. With you, success is guaranteed. Can you stand up and celebrate God? One more prayer, I have a lot of battle.